Halli, hallo. So it's Ivette here, and today we're doing part 3. Oops, let's start like this so everybody can see it better. So, and it will cover pretty much very, so it's my favorite part actually. And I'm a little bit concerned, and I hope, actually we don't have problem before, so this you guys very active in the class, and I really appreciate it. So, and because this one part in the class is very interactive, and I expect and we will communicate also if we use Skype, so that we still can talk, and I need your reply, all right? So what we will talk in today, it's specific of mobile testing. And just to, you know, clarify the error, I don't know this, I hope or I assume that Michael already talked about this many times. So it is about black box, gray box, and automation and white box testing. So I just found very good pictures to finalize this. So then user test, it's what is a black manual testing is. API and services test, it's what gray and semi-automation automation. So automation heavily depends on regression and integration tests. And unit test, which is really this we will talk about when we come to case of emulators and emulators. So then it will be considered white box or used by developers. So yeah, it's a long list of different questions. I would like to talk today. So in the start with right straight to the points. Then we already talk mobile testing, but what is this? So what exactly you test, or, you know, it's also have some specific domain. So in it's actually three types of mobile domains than we normally as a tester have hands on. So in the first one, it's a downloadable mobile application testing. And at this point, we can talk about native application or hybrid application. So, but anyways, this distinguished feature of this testing, so generally, so then it's we use our QA site. We can use pre-production. We can use some developer sites. So, but it will be during the testing shared with you from the customers or from the developer side as a link. So this, when its product is done, when module is done, then actually this product will go through the download, so as a download, so installation through the store. It doesn't matter, so it will be iStore or Google Play, whatever. So that is what we're talking about, downloadable mobile application testing. So this another big portion of mobile testing, it's mobile handset testing. So there primarily we use only native application. So in sometimes this native is confused. So I talked about native application last time. So in the beginning when we have feature phone, maybe like 10 years before, so then 10 years ago, then native application was in the meaning, so like preset. When you buy a phone, some applications already exist, and it was considered native application of the device of the phone. So these days, it's a much more broader definition of native application. So pretty much any application that creates specifically for platform, so specifically using a specific language or specific framework or so environment, so this we already talked about this last time, so we'll consider native. But in the case of mobile handset testing, we heavily have integration testing between SMS, MMS, voice call, phone books, calculator, Bluetooth, and so this we just check primarily, and we also check multimedia. So and mobile protocol stack testing, and I will talk about this in a couple of minutes. So the third part is called mobile website testing, it's web sites. And it's just, it's all access through the internet, so via browsers. Naturally, then when during this testing, this major point will be integrity, how the browsers, so this is the browser available. So you will use multi-browser for testing. So, and you remember this in a mobile world, we have a lot of different browsers. So, it's proper navigation, good user interface, so design, security and performance, it's what is important areas of websites testing. And I think I prepare some slides so then I can give you some, share a link with you, then you can try to, you know, just for exercise purposes, so because special website for testing exists, so then you can just go and try to, you know, to find bugs, try to, so just do practical exercise in the real world. Okay, so, yeah, web testing, it's mainly then I want to concentrate. Why? Because it's a, like, unknown area, and it's a area then easy for you to catch, so before you start work, and it's very good for exercises. So if you just, you can Google on internet, so for web testing, I don't know, free, so something like that, resources. So, but generally, so wireless application protocol is a technical standard for accessing information over mobile wireless network. So, in website is just like website, but specifically for mobile phones. And, you know, this is, we pretty much this, it's a very easy application. So, in it's all, again, very good for learning purposes, because it's like most of it experimental, so then it's very buggy. So I give you this, you know, this names of all these protocols, so then you just have idea, so what possibly, you know, this under what protocols testing could consider, so then you can just explore. So it's all self-learning stuff. So, what is a different way you can install mobile application? It's like very generic, so very simple question and a very simple answer. So actually we can just take, where I go? I skip it. Da. So, first one, it's a firmware over the air. So in these days, it's also very common over the air, just OTA. So when we just using GPRS and SIM card or internet connection, so then we're done. Wi-Fi or data cable, USB cable, so and Bluetooth. It's pretty much four ways in how you can install mobile application. So for example, if we talk about downloadable stuff, and it's QA, not pre-production, so sites, so not production. More likely, then you will get just a link, and it's a normal daily practice. So can you believe, for example, when they start testing, so you have normally this for mobile devices, 10 cases per hour at a minimum. So normal, so you execute about 70, 80 cases a day. So don't worry, it's not like three pages cases. Sometimes it's just one lane and say, hey, push this button and see where, is it just redirected to next link, yes or no. So pass, fail. So very simple stuff. So, but for, you know, for generic things, it's like a golden rule. So if you want to make sure and validate, so then it's a really legitimate case. So because sometimes, you know, this when you go back and forth, so something may happen to the, it's still not fully developed site. So then pretty much every time you start case, you need to clean up. And for example, I work right now on iPhone 5, so every day, for almost for each case, I go back and forth to settings and clean a cache, clean a history, so and start all over again. So how I start all over again? I don't type all this link. It's pretty much long link. So then my managers, or I send it already a couple times, updated version, to my own email. I just open email and open link from email over and over again. It's daily practice, and it's a normal, so this is how this we do this on a regular basis. So just for your knowledge, it's another way to, I'm not install applications, so because again at this point it's not in production yet to install. So, but it's just another tip for you. So if somebody asks you, because it's common, a question in interviews, they ask like, hey, do you know copy and paste, how you can copy and paste from your email? Because, for example, it's like to finish this start. So maybe it's not in a question way, but so it's still, I think, will be helpful for you to know. So when you found something, whatever mistake, or you have a screenshot. So again, you have two way. Yeah, you can connect it through the USB cable and upload to your desktop every time. So this screenshot then you already made on your phone, or you can just send it to yourself email. So, and it's many people prefer that. Or for example, and many times, so this developer ask you exact direct link. So where this defect occur, or where this mistake so is found. So how you do that? Again, you just copy and paste this in your email and send it to yourself. And from there, this from desktop, you implement this. I work with HPQC, so then I implement this in defect track and base. Okay, so go for it. Next question is, what is the difference between mobile testing and mobile application testing? You know, it could be very difficult question for somebody, it could be super easy. So to answer this question, like in 1 second, you just need to know what is mobile testing is and what is the mobile application testing is. So, and the answer is simple, because mobile application testing is a part of mobile testing. So mobile testing is contain three major parts. It's mobile protocol stack testing, user network simulators, multimedia testing, and feature testing. So it's all together. It's mobile testing means then it's a complete testing of mobile on system level and application level. So mobile application testing deal with only with feature and multimedia parts. So then it's just two-thirds of mobile testing. So very easy. Let's talk a little bit about so the special mobile testing part. So mobile protocol stack, actually as the black box tester, you barely will ever deal with that. Or if you work, so for example, one of my friends, so this work with some special specific company with semiconductors, so yeah, they pretty much day by day do Wi-Fi, so this protocol testing, so which is also considered so under protocol stack testing. Yes, then at this point also as a black box guy, he will have hands on it. But in real life, this most of Silicon Valley, you know, they work already with some software product, not a hardware product or some operation system. Yeah, some major company work with some operation system product, but most of Silicon Valley companies, and a thousand of them, they work with really like application frameworks or application software level. So at this point, you will never really know and never touch mobile protocol stack. But it's good to know, you know, just so for professional, so this usage, then so definitions such as handover or handoff or a frequency hopping spread spectrum. So I don't need to read this slide for you because you will get this right after presentation. So, and you can always come back as usual, so that's right before your interview, so to check what is this all about, to refresh your memory. So the second part is multimedia testing, and we talk about, it's again, most of it's automated, and we're using the simulator manually, so this at this point as well. So because, yeah, we will talk about the difference between emulator and simulator, but simulator work with software, not with hardware. So in it's MIDI polyphonic tones, ring and player, go under test there, MP as a ringer and player, and camera and video conferencing. So in the last, yeah, this here, this I found very good schema. You know, this, and I think I told to you last time, so then one of my friends so create some portfolio and uses during interview. So it's why I put this picture, because I think it's a super cool this to print for you, cut top, cut bottom, and keep it just in your profile when you go to interview, because it's a one of explicit form of multimedia testing. So, and the last one is a feature testing. I think everybody understands. It's pretty much everything that you find. So every preset, preload application, so in your phone, so like a phone book, SMS, security, calculator, gaming, so fast dialing, anything possible. So, come now this, you know, it's very common questions, so this compare web application testing versus mobile application testing. So, and you know, it's interesting because when I ask people this, I always try to trick them and it's like, okay, what do you think? What is more difficult, more complex and advanced? So web application testing or mobile application testing? So what will be your answer? So give me hands. Oh, I mean, write this down. So, web. Okay. Anybody else? So, Bogdan is think then web apps testing, same. All right. So, I'm actually glad. Mobile, good. Your question. So, you okay. So, what, no enthusiasm in my voice? Then you already start questioning. Mobile, okay. Mobile. So, actually, guys who say mobile is right, and I can just really, you know, pursue it very easily. So, I create some special table. So, under, we do testing under some certain category. For example, we use some device for testing, platforms, operating system, browser, and user interfaces. So, and when we compare this web application and mobile web application, it's very simple. So, how many devices we use for testing? Okay, PC, laptop, maybe server. So how many devices we can use for a mobile web application? It's a huge variety of devices. So then, boom, mobile is already win. So platforms, okay, how many platforms we really use for testing so on PC? So it's like Win, Mac, maybe, so Linux, okay, maybe Unix, maybe. So like Oracle something, so against, or Apache, or something like server related, but really not too many platforms. So, but how many platforms we know for mobile, so this devices, okay, we talk about 10, but it's more than 20 these days. So we come back again to operating systems, so Win, Mac or Linux is for web application, and really, really long list for operating system for mobile devices. So the same things with browsers, the same things with user interfaces. You remember we talked about, so the last time then, so for mobile devices you can have really like special your preferences or maker preferences or carrier preferences. So what user interface they will use on specific devices. Boom, just from this number, so this you understand then, coverage on mobile web application testing will be much bigger and much advanced and much complex. So, and actually this, you know, I mean, it's very simple explanation. So you can print this table, you can create this table. So during your answer, it will be very helpful. But this one question gave me a job. So 3 months ago, I just answered this question. So to so for company CEO than I, where I work right now. And he was telling me like, okay, my interview is over, so when I can start? Okay, so just take it or leave it, guys. So it could be your winner question, all right? So how you usually explore new mobile devices and phone? I understand, and I think your first response will be like ad hoc, ta-da-da. So, but, you know, like try to extricate yourself from end user point and how as a professional you will start explore new device. So give me some idea, just give me some, write something. So how you will, I mean, beside then you turn this on or start button, yeah, I will do this too. So but what happened after that? So where you go first? So it's a brand new phone, you never have this in the hand. So what you will do with this phone first? Where you go? Menu, make a call. I mean, settings, very good, settings. Okay, for example, make a call. This, I just answer your question, you know, I mean, or suggestion. So for what reason? If application have nothing to do with really calls, so they work maybe, I don't know, with some statistic or whatever, some it's a game. So what is the reason to make a call initially, you know? So this, we always start, and I will not go to apps either, so because first as a professional, I will go to settings. Now, this, I'm sorry to bugging you guys, but hey, so what I will go in setting first? What I'm looking in setting first? Okay, I'm in settings now, so what? So what is the next step? About, good. So to check my version, yeah, whatever, feeling better. So, but about, it's a good way to go. So what is the next? I'm looking for specific keywords, so nobody go there, and it's where you start, actually. So after you found about, so cool, so I'm an update version or version Wi-Fi, exactly. We look for connection. So this is the first things, we go to settings, we look for so version of operating system version, so device, whatever this to check, so then we're in the right track, so this to start so exploration or whatever this under requirements, then so our this who is our employer, so they say give it to us. But so the next in the most important step is to go and check connection. So and after that, this we have bunch of different things to do. So we can also explore so this usability and navigation and notification bars. So what phone is actually can do. So and how it can do and things like that. So and but. And actually, this, you know, this again, so sometimes it happened and they really, like, give you a device in the hands. It's like, okay, here's a device, so how you will start testing. So it happened to two of my friends. And actually what they was looking for, and my one of my friends was smart enough, so he got his job, so too, because he was looking website of this company before. He was looking, so he was aware of what product. So this is they're working on, and so really what direction, so in what connection this other native application could be, so related on this special application that this company was developed. So and it's why this, when he started explore this phone, he was mainly concentrate on this special feature. So that one of the major native feature, then it's like, I don't know, any application then will escape. So it's accelerometer. So, I think I'm already tell you about accelerometer. Then it's a special native application, pretty much in every device. So which is control rotation of your phone from landscape to portrait view. So and yeah, we always look for such things like SMS or call. I mean, it's a secondary, but we always it's still important because when we go to interruption testing, so then it will be one of the major things that we exercise. So. Okay, anyway, this come back to our questions, how we usually explore new mobile device. So after we go always to check a settings, and I will, like, if I have time, again, it depends on the time, so I will go through the old settings and see what my phone can do, and so what program is already preset. So I will go to application management, so to see what is already there and things like that. So if it will be Android device, I will immediately concentrate on so you know just connection and synchronize things, so to set up email or whatever, so to see this is, you know, everything is set up, because Android is not really preset anything, it's a customized device, then you start from scratch. So it was just like an easy answer. If we go to advanced answer, this depends on the company, you know, and depends on the level of your expertise, so I don't want to push you like over your limit. So, but I'm, you know, one of the good things, check in the beginning, so before you start any testing and you got new device in the hand, so it's a power consumption, sensitivity to charge, so check things like disk space, stability, and so limited disk space, things like that. So I already tell you accelerometer function, so we check again connectivity, but more on level like active sync, USB, so Wi-Fi, list of Wi-Fi, this check this is a VPN available and things like that, so Bluetooth, so working condition of unstable compounds, so this it's when we go to look on emulator and simulators, so check stability of application for incoming and outgoing calls, so sending and receiving MMS, so I mean, and check also correct geolocations. And one more thing, this you will see on a left side, so on a slide, or maybe it's your right side, so but you know, I told you this last time, then it's, and I give you a link, so at least for Android we have this log collector available, and for iPhone I found it was like a log, so iPhone device log or device viewer log, So it's also free application. So this is similar, not really good like log collector, but still something. So also another good thing, it's a Wi-Fi analyzer or Carrot. Carrot, it's for free in the app in the iPhone store. In Google Play and iStore. It's a full day of work. So because Carrot is actually a fun application. They show you usage of battery, but they also show you this what other apps you can kill and how much life prolongation you get immediately. It's very interactive, so this in visual, so then it's why I like it. So, but all these small things, you know, help tools you can install immediately on your device and use this for your testing. So, and show this how professional you could be and you are. So, how would you test UI of mobile application? It could be like, oh man, it's easy. But when I start talk to people, I was like, all right, so here we go, how you will start test UI. So what you will do first, how you start UI testing. How's any testing start with what? How we start to test? Besides, then we explore device, look so for version, so we find out what version, then we have connectivity, so load application link. Okay, cool. So, Ala, you are ready to go. So, and when you load or install, doesn't matter. So in our case, we like pretend. Thank you. Thank you too. So we pretend like, okay, we use some store application. So we just take some and download. So then what? So first, how you start testing? What is it during installation you already can do for function and usability? Any answer? Any idea? No? Ala, man, you learn. Veresh too. Do I say your name right? Play Store. Okay, Play Store, I can, yeah. So, but during installation, it's already a lot of things happened. Who know what? Oops. So, okay. After smoke test and environment. Smoke test, manually it could be also, so at some point in some organization it's considered like almost exploratory things, and some, it's under different definitions. In some organization, I have this in the past, so it was just prerogative of developers, then they do first. Or we have some special senior person who just, go through the system because know product well, so just to get to see if it major function work fine, then it's stable, okay, go ahead for everybody. So, but be honest, I doubt it then, like, as this new common in the company or tester. I mean, yes, if it's like easy some application wise, then you may get some very quick smoke test, but it will be not your priority or not your major daily function. So we install application and start with splash screen. So splash screen is a special pop-up things. Yeah. So pop-up screen, then, it is supposed to come like 3 seconds for every download or initiation of some application. Normally, it's a name of application there, some trade logo or something. So it's why it's called splash screen. It's come and go. If it's more than 3 seconds, if it's like loading forever, then it's a performance issue which you already need to report it. So, but already during installation, we already have button like accept, download, open, uninstall button. So all this button, it's already functionality testing we need to come through. So we also have some special sync view loading. Everybody was 100%, so I'm familiar with special bars or some special indication like it could be circle, it could be line, so but it's shown you and it's already usability testing and UI testing, so because how is it user friendly, how is it user intuitive, so how is it indicate for the user installation process, so how is it indicate so progress of download or uninstall application. So it's already, we already start testing, so it's already test cases for this, and it's one of the first initiative so this cases when we have for mobile devices or for any application. So when it's done finally, then we, you know, this normally, believe it or not, this after application install first time, so then we pretty much immediately uninstall it. And to see how easy, quickly, and clean, so this cut, we can uninstall application. And it was so funny, my first experiences of, and you know, this, we was working as in a small group, like 5 people, so, and it was our first experience to download, so, and install something, and everybody was so happy, it's take like forever, you know, 15 minutes. It's funny to think about this right now. So, and after we install, everybody was relieved, the teacher say like, okay, and now uninstall. And 80% people in our group was like, no way, I just finally installed it. I'm so happy that I'm installed. How could you do this to me? I will never uninstall it. So, but it's our daily life. You know, this, believe it or not, I mean, at least 20, 30 times a day you install and uninstall something. It's like no big deal. It's just back and forth, back and forth. So it's actually kind of fun. So to see, is it break it by install and uninstall things. So one of the things, install, uninstall, and install again, all right? It's a first step. So after that, we're looking for general look, like image and text alignment. So like, okay, is the site look good, or it's like everything is in a place? Oh my goodness, it just really don't look good. I don't know where to start to write the box. So, and when we talk about layout, it's we talk about how well it's fit form factor, and I told about form factor before. So we have like a, so right now this most popular is the touch screen devices, but we still have some feature phone with like a candy bar, or some we have like a taco shelf for game console, so like we use a latest one, or we have some 3DS, you know, just so things, or I mean it's many different physical forms of device. So then we need to see this, how this application or program is fit inside this form factor. So naturally this is most common things to check. So for resolution, screen size, alignment, so truncation, I don't know this, anybody know what truncation is? So if any example of truncation? No? So it's when, you know, like you read a word and boom, half letter is gone, or couple letters is gone, and you pretty much can, sometimes you can, sometimes you cannot just think what kind of word it could be, but it's already bug, so it's a truncation issue. So invalid and garbage symbol, it's not like a completely trash garbage symbol, but so for example, unexpectedly you have some exclamation mark or question mark, so in the middle nowhere. So, and it's happened many times, so when we come to localization, so when we use different languages, or we use some Asian languages which involve two byte characters, some hieroglyph like Korean or Chinese or Japanese languages. So, and naturally we're also looking for orientation, portrait versus landscape. You cannot believe, guys, how many bugs you can find in one day just by turning your device from portrait to landscape and back and forth. Specifically overlapping issue, it's just, it's a super common things. It's just most what you obvious things that you will find. So, and the more likely it's exactly related, so integration and the compatibility, so this issue with accelerometer and how this code written on the application, so for this special orientation function. So, my favorite subject is a button. You know, it's hard to explain. Normally I use like all this so board, so then we have in a class, so then, you know, just okay, but tell me how you will, what you can do with button. You already have answer, but so this still, so what else you can do with button besides, and I already, so this you can see on my slide. Push, yeah, it's a functionality issue. So beside push, active and disable, yeah, it's what is, I already have this, so on my list. But another thing, so how you will test place on the screen, how you will check, sorry, I didn't see. It's okay, it's cool. I still believe you, then you know, it's cool. Yeah, it's UI testing, exactly. So it's a part of UI testing, but you know, this what I try to bring your attention. So, because, you know, when you talk about UI testing, you can talk about buttons like for 5 minutes straight. So, and people, as an end user, yes, it's only things that you will mention in the first place, it's a push a button. But as a tester, so you have like at least 20 different functions around the button, what you can do with the button. So you can move this around, so you can like use a scrolling, yeah, exactly, navigation. So this function, so to check, so how the button works. For example, if I scroll or touch a button and move this up, scroll this up, so in the release. So what happened to the button? Is it come back to the same position in the middle where it was, or it's will stuck somewhere on the top? So the same things if I go left and right, so this different, you know, just any possible direction. So what happened to my button? So if, for example, I try to, so size adjustment, if I try to expand my button, so what happened to my button itself? Is it color change, so resolution change? If I have text inside the button, what happened to the text inside the button when I expand it, so, or, you know, shrink? And I have this link, so later for you, but you can just, you know, this have this like, so in memorize this in your brain. This I have like right now, I'm falling in love with new UI, so from Japan, it's called AIDA, so A02. It's what they do with, it's amazing what you I was never thinking that I can do this with simple button on navigation bar, what they do with that. So I think I have links, so then you can, I really encourage you to check this video. So from YouTube, it's like some set of short video for 2-3 minutes, because it's amazing, but it gives you perspective. So what you possibly this day, crazy things can do with some simple button. And when you come to interview and UI question come on the table, you will be prepared, because you will talk about this with enthusiasm in your voice. It's like, man, guys, I can tell you. And you will just, you know, so they will be also see you differently, because you will not give them traditional answer. I will push a button and that's it. Okay, so and naturally as well, come back to your UI testing of mobile apps, we look for links. It's one of our major things that we troubleshoot all the time. So this connection and how this any possible button, bar, arrows, checks, mark, whatever, some special symbol will guide us or direct to link us to something else. So, and I really encourage you guys, you know, it's, yeah, we naturally have like special dictionary books written so for special professional language and web testing or web design and things like that. So I'm not encourage you to read all of them. So it's, I mean, it would be nice, but never will have time for that. So, but you know, this maybe use 3-4 words, then easy for you to remember, and you know this. What does this mean? So, and use this all the time when you try to describe things like navigation bar, scroll view, tab strip, and things like that. So, because it's very important, so it's also represent you as a professional and not just like end user who decide to enter a new profession. So, and yeah, this another like special word, like so for touch screen UI, we have panning. Panning, it's when you go to left and right. You can say swipe, so but swipe, it's again from the beginning, entry level. So people who is more professional, they use professional words. Scrolling is up and down, panning is left and right. So we also just one of this like, you know, things I brought this so this picture, if you see tabs. So I like really this picture. Why? Because in one picture you can see how differently tabs could be represented. It could be all this stripe with some set of symbols. It could be just like a checkbox and it's considered already tab. So it could be some word or it could be some graphical representation and it still will be considered tab. So, but when we're talking about touchscreen UI, we also keep attention for notification, and we look for add-ons, And we look for our authentications for client certificate. So user password. I know this, you already tired from this username and password. So, but it's one of the, not really must things, but so it's still there. So we're still testing this every day. Yeah, I just refresh your memory with mobile form factors, so then you have this handy and don't need to go to other presentation. So, and I already mentioned that it's a many, many different so mobile UI exist. I don't say then you need to know all of them. So, but at least, you know, was one time question. So this for one of my friends, because so she was bragging about too much, like, yeah, in different UIs. Like, okay, give me example of any UI that you work with. It's like, oh. So, but most common for Android because of popularity of Galaxy S, so Samsung devices, it's a TouchWiz. And for iPhones, the most popular, where is it? Oh, okay. Yeah, OmniGraph, so could be. But again, it's like 20 of them. So this, you welcome to explore, you know, this, so then you can have, say something, couple words about. So, and I told you this, I just mentioned this, AIDA, so info bar, it's where the link, I put the link. So I really encourage you to go there, then you will be on the top and you can talk about, because, I mean, it's exciting. So how does people, what people do with simple UI? You will never think that it's possible to do some with UI layouts, such as things. And it's already there. So I'm waiting for this phone, it's HTC phone, which is supposed to come maybe in 6 months to United States. So I'm ready to buy it. Okay, so tell me about test plan specific that must emphasize while writing a test plan for mobile application. So we come back again to this over and over. It's in like in every other job description or you know, the job specifications. So then, are you have something to do with test plan before? Are you able to do test plan? I mean, I don't know why it's come in question, because as a black box guys, we're not really like obligated. It's not in our job description to write test plan completely. So there should be in the edit. Oh, what were we talking about? Okay, I lost it. We're talking about UI still. I'm sorry. It's all right. It's okay. So, but we still part of the team, and we want to be a good part and productive part of the team. So it's why this we involved in many different so puzzle pieces, which is together come to the great test plan for mobile application. So, and you know this when it's why generally we need to know conceptual this how the test plan for mobile application is written and what is under consideration. So in the first place, you know, it's come requirements analyze and consider mobile factors. So this, what kind of media files is going to be support. So what kind of internal memory or SD card will be, so this in use, and how it's, you know, this what happened if it's not will be available. So, or what happened if SD card will be changed, things like that. So if we consider GSM, so devices. We also start with UI mockups, and it's actually come from client. So then they provide some screenshot or sometimes just very explicit descriptions of how they want to see or how the application should look and things like that. Sometimes it's just a sketch. So then you can see this as a sketch. So, and before any testing started, so, you know, time then, so this study architecture and technology, so they look for, you know, this competitors, so they look also this, what kind of new technology possibly will be involved in their project. So this, as they have really technical tools or technical support to use all this. So it's one of the, so this, what kind of API, what kind of framework will be used. So this, and things like that. So this, what is another resources will be involved. And now it's one of the part of preparation. And as a team member, you know, this, they always like, hey guys, we start new project, we start new process. So anybody have idea, anybody have already like some presets from previous experience, so you are welcome. It's we can also say in simple words, it's a brainstorm. So and many times, so this we all involve this, everybody, so opinion is count. So this is about strategy, resources. I mean, so but it's just general words, so we you can answer this in general words, or you can just go a little bit more specific and deeper. So for example, this, you know, when we talk about competitors application, so this we you know this to how we can beat everybody up. So I have a story for that, and it's what happened, a real story to me. This it was one of my first project again, so two years ago. So, and the guys was startup, so from Latvia, so they decided to, you know, just to beat up some mugshot or so this photo bucket, so this all this you know, in Picasso. So, and what they did, so that nobody was know this guy, so they was like nobody. So, and they got second place in the rating in within 1 year. So what they did, it was just very simple. They was not really like a scientist. So they just collect all application, it was like 25 at this point, so related competitors in the market, so kind of like Picasso or some photo sharing, so something, whatever. So, and they just collected and analyzed all of these applications. So what's the most useful in each application, what people like. And they just combine all this feature then so people like in one application, and they got a second place. So it's how this really this it's bring to success, and how the small things like analyzing of competitors can give you really good backs back, so payback. And when we talk about testing approach, so this it's a lot of other different things, like so this what exactly we will you know, just hardware, software, carrier, so network technology use, so what kind of operating system will be considered so for our application. So, and for example, like today, this I work with application, so if they looking for people who is like rich people, so who have money, so they not considering old technologies, so they just oriented only on the people who have latest update of everything. So, I mean, it's a they target. So they oriented on people who have, yeah, sneak peek, exactly. So it's what I was talking about. I worked for sneak peek when they just started, so 2 years ago. So, and when we talk about mobile application testing scope, I think it's a good diagram, then also you can just print and use for your portfolio, because I already mentioned then each of specific so domain or special mobile applications, such as a native or web, so this application, you heavily related on some certain part of testing. So like for native, we will do functional regression and unit testing. So for web interface testing, we will heavily related on mobile browsers compatibility, so in support of HTML5 or JavaScript standards, things like that. So it's again, I think this, I like a live picture, and I think this in our profession, it's we all so easy to visualize people, so then when it's visualized, then maybe it's easy to understand. So, but keep going on this test plan. So we also keep in mind, so target device, so what is primarily device we will sell our application, and possibly this again, it's so orientation is on the newest one, not on the oldest one. So, or maybe it's, you know, we still have a lot of application or some special resources for third world country, and I have also slides for that. So then, you know, it's like, it's market is still there. So also if a device costs 40, 30 bucks, so people still do in the, so at the end of the year, millions of dollars. So by selling some very simple phone, so but that phone can save lives. So this phone, so this is still very helpful and useful in some third world countries. So and when we talk about test plan, then we start before testing. So it's already some design scenarios and test cases created. It's actually not come always from us, from testers, believe it or not. So because specifically in Agile, so this we have such a term as a story. And story, it's like in classic version, it will be business requirements or business specification. So very detailed some scenarios or use cases. So this where they just describe what happened if some guy wake up in the morning and decide to take a phone and ta-da-da-da-da, and it's going on and on. So very explicit step-by-step. So this what happened and what the user can see if they open page one, and from page one they tap on the button so-and-so, and it will direct to button so-and-so, and after you can see this, this, and this. So very, very in details. So but again, after this story is written, based on the story, we do smoke testing. So because the story just in the beginning show you some main function and feature of the application or program. So and based on the story, so we already starting to make some tiny test cases. So and it's actually this funny, you know, this, I always jump ahead. So this I need to bite my tongue and wait for a couple of minutes when we come to the specific question, then I will ask a specific question. So Ala, you in the mood of writing today, man. So this okay. And one more thing is, you know, when we talk about techniques of mobile application testing, so we should not forget that it's not just like manual or automated testing. It's okay. So it's much more than that. We have like remote manual testing, which is considered to be semi-manual testing. So with RDA devices such as Device Anywhere and Perfecto Mobile. Or we have testing using emulators, which is also considered pretty much gray box testing. So emulator and simulators. So emulators is related to create testing around hardware. So simulator to create testing around software and browsers. So, and performance testing or things like if we do some regression testing, so all the time it's a heavily automated testing. But it's good as regression, so it's just a name. But so we know this regression is every time it's code modified, so we need some sort of check. So it's, it could be also related to integrity, compatibility, and functions. So, but it will be all named as regression testing. So we need also to analyze tools and utilities. We need to keep performance in mind. And at this point, performance is a very huge subject. And you know this, I failed one of my first couple interview. So because I was like ready to talk about functionality, usability, security for this matter. So, but every time it's come to performance, I was like stuck and bite my lips and like, oh my gosh, okay. So I have something to say, but I don't know what. So specifically, it was very simple question. So did you have any experience with performance testing? So generally, it's like in theory, yes. So then give me any example of what kind of testing could be considered, so should be considered performance testing. And here I'm start choking. So it's like, give me any examples of what kind of performance testing tools you use. It's like, oh my gosh, I am out. So I'm history. So, do we need to write our plan? Not really. So this, what you need to do this, so Ala asks, you know, on daily life, so this, if company really does ask you, so this, to write any test plan, I barely hear the story, this, you know, some part, maybe, so like, for example, based on the story of, or user mockups, so they want you to create some first set of test cases. Yeah, it could be possible, but it's a really small portion of test plan in full. So, but I doubt it that you will ever, because it's a manager responsibility, and it's actually this always collective document, which is go through the many meetings and adjustments. So, in, you know, in Agile, it will be a Scrum Master who will do this, and Scrum Master, it's a special certified manager position. So, this you will never really, so to put and compile this document together. So, but test cases, it's another story, yes. Again, depends. As a newcomer, I doubt that if you come first day, I mean, it must be like really a super startup who is tight on money, time and whatever. So then you come, and then the first day you start writing test cases. So when you come, believe me, this any organization give you at least 1 week, of, so the, also if it's agile. If it's not agile, then a big company can give you up to 1 month. So where you just sit and look for documentation, stare at what other people doing and doing something, but not really like daily activities then, and not heavy load like other people. And it's like, man, when I finally start doing something. So it's like, so always start, get slowly. And that's why you don't need to worry. So they give you time to catch on. So to, if an organization have a lot of documentation, you will have a time to go through this. If they don't have any documentation, you still will have time to explore a product, explore devices, techniques, and tools they're working on. They give you training on everything, or at least they give you some body, so like a senior vice, so it's not supervisor, it's just the person who will guide you and who you can ask questions, so at least like collect all your questions so through the day, and so create some short meeting and ask all questions once a day. Or if you like cannot so wait, then at least you don't ask every 5 minutes, you ask maybe like a couple times a day, so it will be right way to go. So, but here this, I give you some idea of performance testing. Sorry, we jumped today. And because, you know, I'll be honest with you, so this, it's my like experimental lecture. So I never have this lecture before. It's why I have so many things to say, then it's maybe not well organized. So sorry, guys, I'm experiment with you. So how I can organize this for class on Wednesday. So thank you for your understanding. So, but I don't want to read this through, so because, again, it will be in your hands, but it's good, you know, to have, like, ideas, so what direction performance testing go to, and what you really this can just pull resources from internet, so if you see then companies somehow this, you know, related or work with performance testing. So, and again, another is a diagram, so this very representative, very visualized. So what kind of testing on mobile devices and really this, in what kind of load, intense and frequency this you will do. So smoke testing, yeah, it's very common. So this, you get new version. So before you start, you know, really this, put some heavy load of different testing, some automation or something before it's collapsed and broke and application is like in critical stand, so then we do smoke testing. So basic acceptance. We don't have too many really cases for that, just cover general function, so general feature. So we have pretty much every new build, so specifically when you work for mobile and agile environment, so new feature testing, it's a part of integration testing or compatibility testing again. Part of regression. You know, you cannot really describe, oh, today we do regression testing. No, because it's all together. So it's so mixed up, then you really don't have name for that. So, all right, in our case, it's a new feature testing. So then we got built, we got some special so feature implemented yesterday or a couple hours ago. We need to, it must be done. So we need to check this. Everything is work fine. So nothing is broken old or so new one function is good integrated. So in today release. So it happened half of the time. I mean, the same things with regression. Why? So this you don't see like it's a frequency is not really high. So because, again, from our perspective, our black box, a big portion of regression testing, because it's a huge test cases and numbers, so they go through the automation. It's automated process in many companies. It's easy because it's again over and over is the same. So like so, tap on the go, tap on the start, so come back button, da 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 da. So it's, I mean, if you do this manually, then you will go crazy because it's only what you will do every day, back and forth, the same function over and over again. It's very repetitive. So it's why this we have a lot of test cases, as you see on the diagram, right here. So, but it's high values to automate. So in compatibility test, yeah, this we do this not all the time. So a lot of our compatibility also could be done, they put medium, but it could be done so with automated resources. So, but once in a while, you know, or when the switch device, or we decide check new version. Because so compatibility on mobiles, it's mainly this meaning behind. So this how your application, how's your product work with a specific operating system, with specific device and specific hardware. So this it's related to performance testing as well. So it's why this you will not do this every day. But you have test cases for this too. Okie doke. Sorry, I'm slow today. So application, you know, this we need to keep in mind, so this to make sure this, you know, this then application met also special criteria to satisfy its special store. We talk primarily for proprietary system like Windows Phone or a BlackBerry BB10 or if we talk about Apple devices, yeah, naturally, so then it's a lot of different certification or criteria application should meet. But also for open source like Android, it's just, you know, you don't see it, so and yeah, it's much easier for developer to come through with their product, so you implement this in Android, but so it's not like it's completely anarchy, then, you know, everybody can enter in and put the application and everything. So this because it still have some filters, it still need to meet some at least minimum requirements of quality, so and technical requirements to pass a barrier, so then you application could be successful and could be a competitor with other application on Android market. So, and this criteria is also used so when a test plan is under consideration and in process. So, and yeah, it's a good point, you know, this why is a better crowd testing is or user acceptance testing is still exists. So we have enough professionals, so why they take our breath? So, but as a professional, this and it's true, you know, this you many times, like specifically when you do some big amount of testing and it's like boundary testing or something testing. So this, and here's a good example. If you have some movie app to test, so for 1 or 2 hours, you will not watch all this movie. So you will just take some boundaries points, some in the beginning and at the middle, at the end. So, but as a end user, through the acceptance testing, yeah, they will do this really go through, and sometimes it's some ghost bug or whatever, glucks, you know. So in the middle, then we can miss as a professional because we do this in random, or we just do some only certain amount of testing or skip, or we have also just, for example, we have right now this we call this optimized testing, so because we have over 1,000 tests in which was collected for last 3 months, but hey, we have only 1 week, so we cannot do and perform all 1,000 tests in 1 week. So then also if we do like 100 cases a day, so it's still really pushing. So then we optimize these cases, we don't go through all of them again, so we just check test cases, then we think then really relevant and important for a specific product and application, or for try to look from a user perspective what will be important for user. So, sorry to talk about this lot. I hope I will not confuse you and not overload you with information. But you know, this it's what is a part is was missing when I complete Portnoy school 2 years ago, because it's like, oh man, so if I just know everything like I know today, so this if my life and my interview will be much easier and smooth, and maybe I will get, you know, just so the start the job much with much higher rate. So and I'm finally, you know, this is what a pity, sorry that I'm talking about myself so much today, so but I'm teaching already for 6 months, and I never like really get replay from people because so I help them to prepare for interview, and they disappeared. I mean, I understand and they got a job, so it's why they disappeared. Otherwise, they will come back, and so you know, with some compliance, so like why it doesn't work. So, but it's not like I really need appreciation, but I'm always was expecting and waiting for feedback. Like, hey guys, tell me, so this what is it was really helpful or something we need to talk more longer, da 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 da. So then I finally got this feedback from the guy who just it was really funny because he just started working our company 3 days ago, And so he was my former student, so he got to, so this job through the dice, so nothing related to partner of school. So he found, I mean, he graduated and was following my advices to so explicitly promote himself on the dice. So he finally got this job. But when he come and saw me, he was like stunned, and he told me like, "Do you know this? I read and was going through your so this." Stuff that you give us in class, so this through your presentation, like three times to adjust all this enormous so amount of volume of information. But when I come to an interview, like I was always like a bingo. So it's my second interview, and I got two offers. So because 60% question, then you cover it's I already covered because it was there. So and I already know answer. So, and I'm happy this at least somebody tell me this, then something positive and good, so this happened. And I hope this you will, guys, when you get the job, so this, I expect you to write Michael, hey, so it was helpful, I got it. So, and so this, not just again to praise, but, and if it's something like, hey, you know, I got this and this search and search question, which was not covered, so write this down, so send it to him, because he will give it to me, and I will try to find resources or try to cover it in the next lecture, and you always have, you know, access to Portnoy resources, so then, you know, I always try to update my lecture, so, and you always welcome to come back and to see what is update available. So, and now we have a great plan to, you know, talk more and more about specific mobile tools, so testing tools and things like that. Yeah, cool. Thank you. So, come back. How would you test the mobile apps page? We start as exploratory things generally and have a lot on user interface testing and usability and functional testing. So, and we also look for performance and stress testing. It's just regular general type of mobile apps testing, which is very familiar to software testing in general or web testing in general. So, in security testing, you cover authentication, authorization, so data security, allocation of data in offline mode, protection of file systems, so option and network resources. So, this it's a manual, it's a very simple, we don't go deep. So, but when it comes to specific types of mobile apps testing, I already cover and talk about compatibility. So testing the compatibility of your application with native device feature. So how does well your application, so this work with operating system with other native, so preset application on device, how does very good and economic so use hardware, so like CPU or battery consumption, things like that. So we talk about certification compliance testing, and it actually was the last, so this three students report, and it was common under consideration, so because it was proceed for Oracle, I mean for Sirius really. So if you go like really heavy technical company to proceed, IBM, Oracle, I don't know, Citrix, so this, you know, then they somehow work with servers, with PHP stuff, so Apache things. So 100% one of certification compliance testing come in under consideration. So this specifically for downloadable mobile application. So, and I mentioned some of them. We talk about this little bit later. So I prepare for you special links, then where you can, I don't have time, you know, just to talk about this, but I found the links where you can really explore. If you, again, one of the students last time was asking me, it's like, man, do I really need to remember and know everything? It's like, why we so broad spread? Why we learn everything? It's like, because market is 360 degree. I have no idea what interview where you get, so this way you go to work, what is your background, what is you really want to, so for specific, looking for specific industry or whatever. So I try to cover everything little bit, so then you have something to say about everything if it's come. So of many people just start this profession, they in exploratory mode itself, so they don't know, they ready to get any job, and dance from there, see how this will go, how they like it and things like that. So it's why this, we need to cover any possible information then so may pop up during interview. So this at least like you use your short memory or you create some portfolio, which I encourage you to create. And it's like, oh, wait a second. You know what? This wasn't my last project. So we have these things and you pop up out of your folder. So this specific page, so then you can just like, so have some helpful guide during your answer. So, okay, come back to our list of specific types of mobile application testing. So here's a submission guidance compliance testing. So the application needs to adhere some specific submission guidance, so for publish, so to come through the iStore or Google Play, things like that. We already talked about this. So one of the big part of testing, and it's actually, again, very simple and fun testing, it's interruption testing. So when what happened to your application or what happened to battery consumption or something, so when you interact so during active process, active run of your application with other native services and application of the device. So such as voice call, SMS, notifications, things like that. So SOAK testing, most of the time I heard story this from infotainment or if it's some game related, some entertainment application. So because it's so also relate a lot of hybrid or mobile web application, so specifically when we talk about online multiplayer games, so it's a special, it's a pretty much 90% automated so testing, so where you create condition, for example, what happened if 10,000 user pause your game for 10 hours straight or push some special 3 button so for 24 hours straight, or what happened if suddenly 100,000 people will go to your upgrade store to buy specific armor. Are you have supply enough? Are this application will go crazy and freeze? So, or what happening? So things like that, it's just like really funky, crazy testing. So in my book, so, but it's very, I think this, you know, when you come and put hands on, is it really like you need to be a special type of person to create test cases for such as testing? So I think it will be fun. I want to try one day so to create some crazy test cases. So and big point, I mean, it's a regular, it's again a regular basis, so low network or network case testing. So you remember this I mentioned last time, so this fly mode, airplane mode, it's where we use so all the time, so we have connectivity, no connectivity, refresh so connectivity, change and so switch connectivity to from Wi-Fi to Bluetooth or GPRS or something like that. So and as usual, so overload you with information, but at this point it's not important. I create a table for you. It's more detail specific, because so if you go and you understand and tomorrow's your interview, today if I tell you, I mean it will be wow, cool, fun, but I will not remember anything. So but tomorrow this you can print these things or you can just put this in your bathroom and learn every day, so and create story, this what you did and how you did so this test some certain things on mobile devices, so and it will be very useful for you. Just to, like a short guide, so how you do things and what is could be really specific of mobile application. Many times it's common during telephone interview. So are you have experience test on mobile devices? Yes. So what kind of experience you have? Already in these cases you can cover 3 or 4 so deep technical question, but by go straight immediately, not functional, because everybody understand and you will have a functional usability testing. Go directly to specific, so this of mobile application testing to show you then you know the subject. So and I guarantee you then so I mean be careful with that, so because it could be like plus and minus, so this in one thing again don't cover everything from this list, because you know if you give them too much information, too much specific information related to mobile testing, so in many cases I have my friend, so poor guy, this he was lose 3 interview, and like because every time they send it him like thank you for so this have interview with us, but unfortunately we cannot forward it to you, you're too overqualified. you're too good for us. We was looking for like less level. So, or we don't have really this money to pay you, then, so with all your experience, with extensive knowledge and experience you have. It was one story. Another story that I have, then a person was having this page right on front and just read everything, and it was cool. And after this, you know, people was amazed from her knowledge, and they asking her just like very simple question. Really? So this, tell me about correct localization. So what you was doing? So what kind of localization you perform? And at this point, she's like, I will call you later. So, because, I mean, she have nothing to do with localization. Really, it's localization. It's just so different languages when you run application under different languages. So, and it's a specific area. Again, so I give you idea. Choose two or three, then you can so feel comfortable, maybe have something related to your background. So, or you feel like explore and create a story around this. So, it's don't take too much, because again, when we was, I think I already mentioned this last time. So, but when you work for example, you newcomer, so you maybe have through the, your resume, I can see that you have from 1 to 3 years experience. So within 1 or 3 years experience and more, so this working with in testing so area or just working with mobile devices, you cannot be super expert. Each company use maybe 1 or 2 tools, so maybe if that, so normally just like one, something maybe internal, very easy, so lightweight programs or application, so this for testing. So you can really cover maybe 1 or 2 data tracking base, so in within 1 or 3 year. So you cannot really, so it's so suspicious if you start and talk, then you was so explore and working on 10 different so this products, so this, you know, 10 different tools. So I mean, they will be excited. It's like, really? And they start to ask you questions. So what about this? What about that? So tell me about this. So I did this mistake once in the beginning, and I learned very quickly. It's like, uh-oh. So this only this, so this tell them what they want to hear. Don't give them too much ideas. Then you can possibly know this and this and this. So just concentrate on what they need. What is their product really so direct? Okay. So, and here there's a bunch of slides. So I will not read this through. You will have this available. But, you know, it's will be, actually, I was just like, you know, every time I start digging some subject, I cannot stop myself. It's like everything is interesting for me. It's like, oh, man, I need to do this and this and this. But it was very interesting article. So this, where this, you know, they look from perspective of feature phone, not the smartphones. So what is important feature and how this important testing? So if you create some product or your product is related to some third country development things or third country target. So this, when you try to create something useful, so this for around, for the rest of the world, not just for some Silicon Valley, so geeks and, you know, technical freaks. So, and here this actually, you know, this when you read this article through, you will also understand and gain understanding. So what you also do with specific testing and how it's related to smartphones as well. So, but, so it's just another slide. And to cover this, you know, to complete this question and answer, so when we're talking about testing mobile approach, first, it started always with developer. Developer check this code. I mean, if we talk about some easy stuff like hybrid or web applications, yes, they just check this. Is it HTML code is validated and good, so look good without some really so obvious errors. And the next step in the next test will be performed on PC, just and it's a reason for that, not just to minimize cost or minimize time, no. So because you know, this in the beginning we want to, it's a kind of smoke test. It's also, it's, you don't take a days for that, it's maybe like a couple hours if that. So but you want to just find major functional bug of application itself. So without minimize and eliminate immediately things like, oh, maybe it's device related. Oh, maybe it's integration and compatibility with device and application system related. Or maybe it's related to so integration and compatibility with other native application of device. I mean, to minimize all these things so that you run this application first on just a regular desktop and to see, okay, it's work. So after that, I mean, it depends on the product. And believe it or not, I mean, people make a big deal about emulators and simulators. So yeah, it's still important. I don't say I don't try to minimize this role, but hey, so I'll be honest with you, in 3 years then I work in this area, so I mean almost 3 years, so this I never work with emulators. It was not necessary because in the company I work with some fun software application, so I also work with server in the past. Okay, we use simulator, but this was like really like completely simulator of some machine, you know, this, and it was, yeah, cost question. But and again, it was a lot of negative outcomes after that, because on the simulator it was looking perfect, everything was smooth, everything was fine, until we finally get a real machine, so this you know, for acceptance testing, and product was pretty much collapsed. So we have 3 months delay just because, so this everything that was test on simulator was absolutely not true. So it's why I'm like very careful with simulator and emulator things. So, but again, in a normal organization, so if you have a real device available, or you, if these days it's very popular, this RDA services, so this remote device access services, then why you need to start with simulator or emulator? Because it will be not really advanced function available, or it will be just, you know, you can test the small pieces. Yeah, you can make some unusual condition or create some special condition and variables then which will never be available on manual testing. So, and that's why it's still useful. So when we talk about emulator and simulator, but again, it's every time it's a specific to product, specific to company. And before I start all this class, I mean, not today, but so this for a couple of weeks ago, I was going just for experiment. For I spent 3 evenings so to take for the last 30 days, so jobs from the DICE under mobile tester or so software mobile tester to see what is requirements. Is anybody interested in put this in specification and requirement job description, then you work with emulator and simulators every day. So from 560 results, I got only 3 company who was put in requirements, then they really look for person who have experience with emulator and simulators. So, I mean, it's how this specific it could be. But it's still there. So, and again, this Alan was asking me about RAD test plan. I'm always recommend, and it's, you know, this, it's work all the time. It's work for me, it's work for my friends, and it's work for people this who I helped to, so you know, to prepare for interview. So if you don't know answer, if you have some any testing start or whatever, you need to test something unknown or so whatever, so you start with your own checklist. Nobody will stop you, so you always can write this as a Word document or Excel, this whatever is easy for you, convenience for you. But you always create a checklist. It's safe your time, it's you know, it's also you will gain this I don't know from your colleagues, so then respect, you know, so because you know what you're doing, so and you will minimize, you actually will find more errors, you will find more defects, and you will learn product faster. So I experience this right now as well. So this, I start with 3 people on the same day. So right now they ask me all the time, so where to find information, how these things work, or how these things work. Why? Because in the beginning, so they was pushing on the buttons, so just to have a fun, and I make a checklist, and I was going to for each area specifically and make my notes. So this what I, so weak points and what is the strong points is, so how the application work so internally. And now this is, I understand how it's work from inside, not just how it's look from a user perspective. So, and I really encourage you to do the same. So we cover this, and you know this how we will test mobile application page. So this is as you see in the text. So get prepared for interview smart way and print mobile application checklist from the answer of question 9, which is the next one. So here this I think I have like 21. So you know you can pull this from internet, and it's funny things. Then every time I was searching on internet or talk to people, and everybody's like, "Oh, did you so just check this one and some major case test cases for mobile devices over and over and over again, again." So and you know it was the same text over and over again. It was the same order, but it was different. Presentation. It was as a text document, as a PowerPoint, as a video, so as the Excel table. Is it any possible way? But it's every time the text is the same. So and it's pretty much I took it as a guide, and it's really work and worthy. So to understand what kind of major test cases you possibly can start if you work with mobile devices. So and this was available for you. And I think I provide also link this if you don't like my layout, you can create your own. So, but this, oh, it's actually, 22. So, this one thinks is a cover. So, and what is your step in performance testing for mobile application and name some performance tools? It's what is a one of the was a difficult question for me than where I think. I mentioned some of them. So, it's why this again, I found very good articles, then you can read if you have time. If not, so you have some, you know, this we already come through this general explanation of it. So, but there's many performance impacting variables. So, besides, you know, this then you need to take under consideration before you start the performance test. So, because you know, this if you're using clouds or if it's a special integration with other third-party services and application. So if it's a content of delivery network, so on the mobile browser and devices, so it's all affect your performance. And it's why of the major so drawback for simulators, because, you know, it's again, it's I brought you already example, but so if they always pointed, so then it's very hard sometimes estimate. So invalidate is was legitimate and good performance testing and simulator, yes or no, because of all this additional extension of so which has come, so which I just tell you. So but here this I create some tips which could be like I mean, from developer side, yes, but again, you know, if we understand conceptual this how it's work, so we also look the product differently under different angle. So this we always like extricate ourselves as an end user, and when we understand how it's work from inside, so we can also understand so this where we can see and find some defects. So we will be more efficient as professional. So, yeah. It's just more additional information. And here's a list. I mean, you know, for me, it was like, if somebody will give me this list, so 2 years ago, it will be like golden treasure things. I will pay money for that. So because we were sitting with our friends, and it was like thousands of names. We have no clue what is this all about. So they more likely advertise blah, blah, blah. So just general words, but nobody really knows this, what kind of tools is that. Is it for performance or for everything, or is it just try to sell something to somebody? So here's a list of mobile web performance testing tools for today. So this most common on the market. So in Europe, it will be Soasta. So, but here this most common is Gomez Mobile RAM, JMeter, so HP Load Runner. So iOS instrumentation, yeah, as well. So, I mean, it's for self-exploration, but at least you have direction to go. I mean, if, I don't know how long it's take me, but in the general, you know, this, I will try to cover at least some of this product. So just to make some presentation or webinars, so go little by little. So guys still need to work, ha, ha, ha. How we can communicate with you? Through the partner of school, this, so, I don't know how you normally communicate. do you like? So, what kind of communication you're looking for? I can give you my email, so if I have time. So, I don't know. This phone is like today's. I have one phone number. Tomorrow I have another one. So, but I can give you my email. So this it's no problem. So this, but again, when I promise somebody to help and I never refuse to help, so this it's only one thing that I help. I'm cannot answer all question. Like for example, people to prepare for interview. How I help to prepare for interview? And I be honest. So because I have like lot of other responsibility in life. So I collect because I'm on a subject and I collect really huge resources for different direction and different subject. Sometimes it's also not really organized, well organized resources, but I collect all interesting links that I found. So maybe it's not today, you know, that I'm looking for, but I always keep this in this, different files. So when person call me and tell me like, hey, I have interview tomorrow, this company Sophora.com, it's like, okay. So are you already been through this Sophora.com website? Did you see what product they have? So what kind of, what they doing? So I'm expect you to come through this website or whatever, what is available and all available information regarding this company through. So this after I ask you this, to send it me your resume, so and send it me job requirements if it exists. So then we can see this, how you can create story around this. So and after that, I can provide you, if we see, for example, some of my friends tomorrow have an interview with Pandora. So, okay, I know this, it's an internet radio. Internet radio, then 100% they will ask you for some, maybe Skype. Skype is the best, yeah. I'm always in Skype. It's my Skype. So, and, yeah, not Michael, but it's me. Sorry, and my... So it's my email. So this again, if it's internet radio, then 100% they will ask you for some internet protocols. So they will ask you for some specialists, so POP or POP3 things, you know, what does this mean, so how it's work. So they will ask you, and some question will be related to network. It will be some technical question related to radio wave, just because, frequency and things like that. So then, okay, you need to go direction. I can give you direction. I can give you some links. In the best case scenario, I have some collection of question and answer of for interview for specific company if it's in Silicon Valley and Portnov School somehow related. But it's it. You know, I cannot go through each question, or I really will not have the time so to guide you and listen your answer, because I just physically will not have a time. So because I'm constantly producing some another presentation or so this have some beside projects, so with my friends startup and everything. So I'm very active person. But again, this kind of help, so just to give you direction, give you clue, so what kind of question will be your interview, this, yeah, you always can rely on me and I will help you, okay? So, hey, let's go, because I mean, I'm now scary, so I still have almost like a half of presentation. I don't know how long you will stay alive with me or just get out. So, just to finish this things with performance, wait a second, what was before? Yeah, so with performance testing, sorry. When we testing any app application, so yeah, thank you. Wherever it's browser-based or not, so performance tool capture, so how does generally this any possible tools work, so performance tools. So it's what, yeah, was my idea, so how it's work. You know, it's replay and report every message. It's pretty much like, so recording first, it's some portion of performance tools always analyze first, so what's going on. So this all these clicks and slides and whatever, swipe, scrolling, so and you name it. So this, and what is special messages is going on between client and application infrastructure. So, and most of the tools, they depends on browser plugin to record web traffic. But some of them, like, so this cloud test and SaaS, so they already like web proxy so tools to record the traffic. So they pretty much so by the name cloud based. So and after this, you collect all. I mean, tools collect all this data. So then, all messages on any device, browser, phone, tablet, so all these traffic messages is recorded and analyzed. And once it's recorded, then you can process all this request, you know, this and look for parameters manipulated, and all these messages will be adjust so to special usage pattern. So this it's go from point A, B, C, and after come back to B, and after skip to C and go to D, things like that. So in based on this analyzed information, so the program can create with human help. So because human will be modified and edited, so this test cases path. So it's general. I try to bring you maybe in a little bit confusing terms, but. So I have this in written forms as well. So how does performance tools generally work? Also, because it could be question as well, like, do you know how this performance tools work? And you can give them just like non-technical, but general explanation, conceptual explanation, and it will be enough, 100%. So, okay, now we come to fun portion. My goodness, I'm just in half, so I hope you will stay with me. So... I'm ready to hear you all evening. Thank you, dude. Okay, I don't know, you go, girl or boy, dude. All right. So, you remember we talk about buttons. So now this here's exercise, and I don't want to show you slide, but I hope that you have all good imaginary things, and just imagine. So then, the interviewer give you application. And all what you can see, it's a three buttons, A, B, C, okay, and it's a black screen, no background, nothing, so no arrows, anything, whatever, so notification, just very simple three button, A, B, C, so, and maybe you have notification bar from the device itself, that's it. So, and they ask you, all right, so in other this things, then if you, every time you push on a button, it's make a sound. So it's not specified, it's make a different sound, the same sound, all right, some sound. So you know then inside the button you have letter A, B, C, or 1, 2, 3, whatever. So, and the question is how many test cases you will run. So give me some number. Come on, guys. So any number then you will possibly, how many tests you can create? At least three, okay. Three, four. Okay, that's it? So, anybody else? Where's everybody? So, I have only like four active students. So, where's the rest of auditory? How many people we have here today? Nine. So, they sleep. Really? Oh, shoot. Okay. So, then you guys get the joke quickly and others will sleep forever. So, that's so fast. Okay. So, I can take it up. Hey, guys. So you can stop writing answer. The right answer is a Jewish answer. So how many you need? And the simple explanation of it is so depends. So how many time we have, how much resources we have, this how really complicated application is. I mean, it's not really complicated, but so how many resources for testing we have? If we have 1 week resources, then why we should do testing in 2 hours? Yeah, naturally, I will create 200 cases, believe me, with three buttons. So, and I will just prove this for you in a couple of minutes. So, but you always answer how many questions, so how many test cases you want to see. So, depends on what time, resources, money, and whatever this we have, I will create for you. So, and when they ask this question, it doesn't matter, it's three buttons, or they will ask you test, so how you will write test for ATM machine or whatever, so for Iron Bread. It doesn't matter, because what they're looking for at this point, and I'm looking from you for answer, so this I just give you clue already a couple times today, so how you start your testing, so how you go ahead everybody else, when everybody starts this ad hoc, what you will do as a super clever guys. Anybody? Give me answer. I wish I can say your name. Vija Shri UI. Vija Shri, okay, cool. Teresha? So what is your answer will be? Okay. So you think it. Oh, cool. Bogdan, yes. Settings. Settings of, okay, what is settings, how it's connect? Good. But you already starting give me clue, guys. If I collect all your answer, UI, settings, how it's connect, so then what I will create of this? Beside test case, what is another name that I already mentioned a couple times? Anybody? Almost. It will be not test plan, it will be your own checklist. So you start with checklist, and why I'm just over and over over talk about this, because when in any interview they ask you question, write any test cases or how many test cases you can write, or so can you write test cases for whatever, some stupid things like a cup of coffee or pen, whatever. So they looking not really for how many cases you will write, but what kind of test cases you possibly can write, what direction you can go. And at this point, so this only way to not think in detail of some usability functionality and stop there because you will be in panic, my gosh, what else? So if by creating checklist, at this point, for example, we have main page, three button, A, B, C. So, and if we cover, so just like I'm looking at this button and say, all right, when I see these buttons, I will cover functionality, usability, UI testing, interruption testing, performance and load testing. I can also continue to audibility testing, security testing, and on and on and on. But it will be enough because just by starting, so like, okay, I can make so many cases you want, so many cases is need for our project. And they say, okay, give me example. I was like, and I will make first checklist. So I will cover functionality testing, usability, da-da-da, what I just give you is like one of example, yeah? And after that, so we start and create cases, depends on each point, so this in our checklist. For example, I say, all right, functional test. So what can I do? I push, stupidly push on the button A, and so it's actually this how this mobile test cases is written in very simplified form. So description, result, you can also put, so it's like an expected result. And actual results, so you can put pass and fail, or you just put some comments. Or many times you also, if it's, again, a lot of organization, you know, it's why? The keyword is, if it's startup or medium size, of like we right now, this I work, it's pretty much a big size company, so 500 people, but we work under like 18 projects running at the same time. So I work currently with HPQC, but this HPQC is not belongs my company, it belongs the client. So, and client pay for HPQC license, so to get in. Believe me, they don't want to pay for 100 license fees, so they bought some minimum license, maybe like 20. So we have right now about 30 testers from both sides, from West and East Coast, to work on this application. So you already understand, then from this 30 people, only 20 have access to HPQC. Not everybody does. So it's why we create over and over some different share a folder, or some company in the beginning use some simple Google Plus, or they create just simple Excel things. So it's still going on and on. So yeah, I mean, the keyword when you have some unknown and you need to test, and don't start your answer with detail. I understand, and it's easy for you to start like, I will push, I will squeeze, I mean, do something what is familiar and easy for you. But don't go this direction, because it's the wrong direction. You will stuck after you push a couple times or scroll a couple times, and it's like, oops, I'm done. So, because when you make a list of what kind of testing you possibly can perform, and on each, for each this of this special testing you have template. So what kind of testing should be covered? So under functionality testing or usability testing and on and on and on. So you can make and produce enormous, you know, this amount of test cases. And as, so they will be, believe me, then maybe, so this, I know this one girl, this, she was following my, so this advice. And she was like, so she was calling me, it's like, thank you, you know, you saved my life because I was so nervous. I don't remember anything. And I was, so she had problem to write in English. So she was really afraid to write test cases. And because she wrote, so checklist, there was, don't go further than that because they was understood then so she can cover different areas. So she already started as a professional, not as a, some school kids who decide to do some ad hoc testing with some three buttons. So, but again, we can explore the things, you know, this combination of button sound. We can just perform very simple things. So verify that when button C is pressed, sound tone C is appeared. So in result, and we press on the buttons and C is should be so audible, things like that. So we go to the next, it's usability and UI testing. So we perform something with these buttons like zooming, panning, swiping, rotation, so this scrolling. You know, this what happened to these buttons, what happened to the text inside these buttons. So it's all, you already create, so you can create really on and on test cases around this. If you scroll only one button, as they go together, as they stay in the middle, as they stay on the side, so and things like that. So if you go to interruption testing, we already a little bit cover interruption testing in general. So this, for example, phone call interruption, SMS interruption, or multiple audible files interruption. So what happened to your poor three buttons with the sound at this point? So, but again, you show them the direction, this, then you knowledgeable in mobile testing because you already so you start with warm-up, with usability, and with functionality. Yeah, it's one of things that we will not escape. But go to specific and make some template of what is always going and covering interruption testing. So, or SOAK testing. So this, yeah, you can say, yeah, this we use so automation for that, but so I really have fun to create some SOAK test cases. So, and I can just create some of them. You know, it's, and again, when you create it during interview test cases, if it's come to this point, it's not mean then, you know, is all cases supposed to be valid. It could be some also crazy or negative test cases as well. So this, they valid or not valid, this will be other point. So just try to be creative and, you know, produce some ideas. So, and we have connectivity testing. So I put this, like, for example, for hopping mode or Bluetooth mode or flight mode, things like that. Going on and on. So, but again, don't forget about checklist. And I will ask you again because we have a couple more examples going on. And every time when you have something unknown, you don't know where to start. You start with checklist. So, like, for example, how you would troubleshoot network issue on iPhone. Also, if you don't know this iPhone, but generally, so you in natural way, you will start with settings, I hope. So, and you go like just to check, is it connectivity there? You check for simply, you know, notification bar. This I read, so in internet resources, it was funny story. So then, you know, you can see notification bar show the network is there and it was three bars, but you go to settings and Wi-Fi was off. So sometimes just, you know, it is specifically for iPhone, then you have special reset button there, then you can reset network settings and it will work. So when we talk about iPhones, it's also we need to take on under consideration then, so this some Wi-Fi is not a good friendship or stand with the iPhone. It's very sensitive. So in a specific, like some big building or factory or some, I don't know, hospitals, many examples, so university. So you can use VPN, so virtual private network. And like I work in electronic for imaging, so this, we have a lot of special lab and we have a lot of dead zone, also blind spot in the building. So then it was preferable to use VPN when you at work. So, and that could be the issue. And we also can talk, you know, just try to experiment. So specifically this iPhone combination of Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi on, so does Bluetooth off, or just switch and see this. Sometimes it recover as well. So you also have an option then, you know, this. So yeah, naturally playing this airplane mode on and off just to refresh and reconnect. So Wi-Fi. Or, you know, you have some certain spot, for example, you know, then at this specific store, I don't know, some bookstore, so your iPhone is always have a weak signal, very bad. So you can go to settings and you will have some special list of Wi-Fi available, and you can actually restrict certain Wi-Fis. Just you have a special option for that on iPhones. So then when you come to this store next time, so this weak signal from specific Wi-Fi will never be chosen. So they will choose any other so available on your list. But again, main idea to explore is naturally this, you need to know a little bit around, so to bragging about network and the iPhones. But you know, also if you don't know and scared, so try to think out of box and try to generate idea which is like go different direction. Also if they invalid. So, but you know, you start always with settings. You always try combination of something, some, or if it's network, always try combination of on and off something and something. So use a VPN, use a different connectivity resources so that available. It will be never so wrong way to answer, never wrong way to go. So, and again, the main things, I mean, nobody expect you then you in the minutes, so produce like 5 or 6, good ideas. But the main point is then also if it's 3 ideas, you know, they like pop up. So then you like energetically producing this idea. You show then you, so just right in front of these guys who will, so and plan to hire you because you like look so really motivated and energetic. So you tell them the story how you solve a problem right in front of their eyes. Also, if you don't know a subject well. So it's what they're looking for. You know, this, they need some quick thinker. They need some quick catcher. So specifically in mobile world. Yeah, and I have like here this for your, you know, exploration, a couple more ideas. So this what we can do with something, audio files, you know, because they're also network related and things like that. So this the main thing is then, you know, this from this 7 ideas I give you, so you don't need to know all 7. Go to sales. So this you will break your, I don't know, template in your head. So it will be not template anymore. So but choose 1 or 2 or 3, you know, create some story, create some paths, because more likely, so network issue, not on iPhone, but on something else will come in and again and again. It's a very common things to ask, you know, it's very easy things to ask. It's actually not for them, from their perspective, from interviewer perspective, it's not really a hard thing to ask. So what is so hard? I don't ask you for any protocols or any specific technical details, how it's work and things like that. Just give me so direction of how you troubleshoot things. That's it. So now the next question is pretty much the same. It's not about network. It's about Yahoo message. So which, you know, this somehow from your mobile device stuck and was never received. So give me 3 different point of view how you will start troubleshoot this issue. Come on, guys. Get your boards run. I need 3 points at least. So from perspective. No. You already go wrong because, Bogdan, you go to details. I don't ask for details. I ask you from point of view. So as a who, for example, so like I am. So this who is... send this message. It's a 1 point of view. What is the next point of view? I don't want detail. I don't want how you go directly to detail, and that's what is mistake. So you need to go from broad things first, from a different point of view. Vijayashree, I'm really on you. So sender and receiver, it's a 2 point of view. What is the third one? I need 1 more point of view. We already got 2. Provider, Okay, it's a way to go to browser. Okay, but how about this? We talk about environment. So what, for example, if it's happened in office, so one thing, then something is wrong with me. Other thing, something wrong with guy this who expect from me email. So exactly, you see, you start to produce idea. Go ahead, guys. I ask you at least three. You already give me like six or seven ideas. But so I try to implement in your head. Don't go to details. What you start check. I know we will go to that. But when they ask you, so how you will troubleshoot this, if something wrong with Facebook, with Yahoo? So where you start? You start not with something pushing and immediately solve a problem. You start with conceptual thinking. So where the problem could be? Exactly, it could be internet connection, whatever you mentioned. But you define area where you will look and troubleshoot for problem. So sender, receiver, internet connection, office environment, and based on this elephants and this special stone, then you define. So you will go deeper in details. But I guarantee you, when you start your answer with square, so this looking for solution from the top, you know, this with the broad things like, okay, I will divide my troubleshoot area in sender, receiver, office environment, network connectivity, so which could be also, you know, like put all together, browser, router, modem, so this you can go troubleshooting there. So you already have four area, four different point of view, so then where you can troubleshoot and find solution. And it's a show you like, my goodness, he's a like academic here, so he's have like really global, so this decision making and solution finder thinking. So this, I really need this person in my team, because other guys is just immediately starting pushing a button, or you know, just, and it's, I mean, this, you evaluate yourself, so this, and show you gain respect immediately just by starting with broad conceptual thinking, not with details. So, and it's at this point again, after we define this area, we can start produce ideas. So what we do, check network connection. So try to send message different device, and again and again. And it's actually very common question. So this Yahoo maybe will be switched to AOL, whatever, or Google something. But they love to ask for this. You know, this what happened. So if something is not receiving, why? Because exactly at this point they don't ask you. So this what you will click, check, or whatever. So this they want you to see this. Different point of view, how you see problem from different angle. Please remember this. I don't know how else I need to like scream at you. Please do this. So next question. I mean, so here you have ideas, and if you be ready for interview, so like you have interview tomorrow, read this through. Right now, I mean, it's not necessary. So we got it, conceptual things. So again, the same exercise. I wish that you sit in my class, because we have fun to watch videos, and this, now this we don't have time for that. So, but I have a link for you. This I encourage you. You know this, because again, it's one of the very simple and common question. So this come. So what is your stress approach when you're testing first time on iPhone? How you start your answer? You have no clue about this FaceTime, how it's work. So maybe you do. It doesn't matter. So how you start your answer? So you have two parameters. You have FaceTime on iPhone. You have stress test approach. So you need to know somehow this what is included in stress testing or whatever, some general conception of stress testing. So and you're more likely you need explore ad hoc or whatever. So or just like I prepare for your video for 4 minutes. So exactly. So to again. Yana, is it your name? Yeah, I hope I say it right. So internet connection camera. You go to details. You already go wrong direction. I mean, yes, you're right, but you will stuck. So your answer will be never complete. You show me this again, then you're not decision maker, you're not problem solving person. You just a simple entry-level tester, then yeah, I will possibly give you like 10 cases a day, and the hope is hope then you will made it. I don't want to put you down. We just talk, we just finish previous question, then we need to look at this question globally first, conceptually. So, and it doesn't matter if it's reproducible or not. So this, how we start this globally. So this, I mentioned already like 3 times in a row, and you still don't get it. Man, how, what word I use? Overload. Overload of what? I overload you. So, okay, maybe, so this user perspective, checklist. Allah, I love you. Thank you. Checklist. Exactly. Checklist. Checklist. So you make a checklist. And at this point, you make, so this, here's a link. You will see this at home. I really encourage you this. It will be good exercise for you. So me too. So at this point, we have pretty much like we can create 2 columns, yeah, from checklist. First checklist will be what general feature so FaceTime possess as application, program, whatever. So, and what, and you know, after we create this list, I create this list already for you, like activation of FaceTime option, so through your iPhone, so new call begin when person call and accept, so first FaceTime invitation, so video call, voice call, switching between front and back camera, and my own picture and video on chat screen. So, when I create this list, what feature or whatever I should cover in my testing, so this, I have now column, so what is my stress condition could be, what possible, how I possible can, give me example, how I will stress my video call. Give me any example. So what I will do, so crazy, wild, over, pushing over the limit, so to somehow really bad interrupt or disturb or disconnect, crash my video call. Walk or drive, good. Video call, think about video, keyword video call. It's always key. Turn on and off many times, good. So, you know, this, you can, so just to think about and use your imagination of what, how wild you can do this and what you can do with poor iPhone. So you can already create for each of this, so items, we can say, on the list, at least 3-5 cases, but you will never come to this because during interview, just by making this list and say, okay, and after I make list of all feature then possibly must be tested, I will start thinking, okay, what is my stress approach for each of this feature, so how I can stress them out, video call, maybe, so because it's a graphic card related, video related, then okay, what happened if I go to daylight, some Arizona light, or if I go to some, try to make some FaceTime call, so under firework condition, or go some disco bar club where like very dark and something strange lights going on. So that, did you still will see me, how good will be resolution on the screen and things like that. I mean, you can, so just use your imaginary. So what happened to your voice call, so that they also can mute it. So when I'm muted and somebody call you, if somebody, and if you play music in same time, or you have another 10 different application on the back running, an SMS message come and so, and somebody try to call you or write you on the Skype, things like that, you know, you just like, so you can, when you have list in front of you, what so this you need to test and how you need to test. So then rest will come in natural way because you just starting, it will be like a fun game. It's like, okay, so how I will screwed up voice call, how I will screwed up so the switch between back and front camera, then I will just put my finger on it, things like that. It's already test case. You can already just describe this in 1-2 phrase or sentences and it will be your test case. You don't need 2 pages of test cases. I tell you, in mobile world, it's like 1 sentence is a test case. Very much. Well, sometimes it's 5-6 steps, but no, not really long. So, okay, I hope by this time, so this, yeah, I mean, I produce more and more things. So you already got idea. So to finalize this again, next question, how you do boundary testing to verify battery life if game application supposed to last for 24 hours? Bogdan is the first in checklist. Good job, man. Okay, so, but the question actually, you know, it's a tricky one because when I first time read this question, it's like, okay, I'm retarded. I must think I'm tired because I have no clue what they're asking. I just don't understand what they're asking. How possibly game application supposed to last for 24 hours? In what mode? Active, sleep, pause? So I don't know any device who today who can run so 24 hours. So battery life is not so extended. So the best device, to a mobile device on the market, it's 18 hours. So it's like, okay, 24 hours don't count anyway. But also, if I don't, I have no clue how I will answer this question, I will start this checklist. Why? Because in my checklist at this point, I will say, all right, I don't understand question in full, but I can divide this question in small portion. For example, I can talk about boundary testing in general, I know. So I can verify battery life. Actually, I can put these things together, boundary testing to verify battery life. So I can have imaginary and make a list how I will do that. So I can talk about game application that's supposed to last. So under different condition, maybe not 24 hours, but so how is this, it's could be. You know, this, when I divide this in small portion and after I try to connect again, but again, I need to, I mean, you can call this checklist, you can call this whatever list, so your own notes, but you try to, you know, this, put this, make this a general picture first. Don't go to details, because if you start and think, really, how I will test this, you will think and you will not have answer, because you will start and think about details, you will not see and you will not create full coverage of it, okay? So, and that's why this, when we have this tricky question again, divide question in small and try to modify this question, then you can answer it. Like, how does the game application affect battery consumption? Yeah. Or how does the usage of battery affect functionality and performance of game? So, and what will happen to the game when battery will turn dead and need to be charged? So what's, is the game will get some graceful notification from the device or from application itself saying, hey, dude, you have only 1% of your battery, so save this game now, stop your level like it is, or you like will lost all level and start all over again, or your data will be not safe, sorry, so I really please you, you need to so just charge your battery right now. So things like that. And again, you can start produce test cases around this. So the main idea, so this, and again, we have, I mentioned this already a couple times, we have a lot of apps for free on the market, specifically on Android, but at this point on the iPhone too. So that I really encourage you to implement on your smartphone today before you start proceed for any job or looking for any job. And starting uses, and just for fun, you know, this to look for this carrot, for example. It's a fun stuff to see this, what you can kill, what apps you can kill, and how much battery life it will save. Or, you know, this, because it's in the same time, it's a performance issue. You see then, so this, how this each application, so third-party application or native application, affect your battery. So, and, you know, when you get familiar with your real life to do this every day, Wi-Fi analyzer, so this log collector, just for fun, you know, to download this log collector or on iPhones, so I just mentioned, I forgot the name, specific device, log something, device viewer log. So that for iPhone, then you know this, you cannot just play with it around, but when it's come to critical moment of interview, it's like, hey guys, you know what, like how you will explore a new device, like, okay, after I'm check settings and connectivity, I will download, before I start testing, I will download log collector. And it's like, why? It's like, because it's for free, if we test on Android, it's for free, and we already have. So look, you cannot believe how people sometimes spend half day, full day, so just to catch a log, to catch, so the zip, you know, to submit this log, because sometimes it's very complicated, specifically on mobile devices. Yeah, device log viewer. I forgot exactly the name. But again, I encourage you to implement this in your smartphone if you have this available today, and start use this for yourself just for fun. Send it yourself message. So you know this, if you make a screenshot and send it to your email. So this, to get familiar with that, because it's a one of really daily life what we have as a tester. So, and it's what is a missing part specifically in online class, because we cannot really have practical exercise all the time. So, but if you, it's it become for you like easy peasy, so this everyday stuff, then when you come through the, so to interview, so this, you will win and gain many points just because you already have this on your phone. And many organizations, specifically when it's come to mobile world, it's a funny. So I mentioned that I was going to make research for this 560 jobs. When it's come to automation, guys, it's funny and it's a scare, because from 560 job description, only 40 companies really know what they're doing and know what exactly this they expect from a so potential employee. So, and they already have some automation tools or whatever tools implemented for mobile testing. Because other guys, when they blah, 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 some experience, some knowledge, it's mean then they have no clue. So this, and they're looking for somebody who have at least something clue, so a little bit better clue than they have. So, I mean, yes, it's a good point. It's a tricky point. You can tell them everything this, and, you know, and you can trick them and get a job. But after that, so you, they hire you as a guru who's supposed to, you know, just develop all the mobile automations. So in their company, and if you have no clue, then it's a like bummer. So, but, right now, currently on the market, mobile automation, it's just a baby. So then it's barely like 2 years on the market. So in, it's why it's not too many tools and not too many knowledgeable people there, but it's a boom. So everybody want for automation. Everybody ready for pay for automation, really big bucks. So in if you catch it, so this, it's like your golden strike, really. So, okay, for these people who, you know, during this question, I was like, man, really, how does you do test in the real world, so battery life test? And that's why I was going to some manufacturer to see how they really, so this test the batteries in the real world. But anyway, this, I hope you got idea by this time. Always make some, doesn't matter how you say it, checklist, whatever list, but so just make some concept. Different point of view, or what area should be covered, and under what condition or what variables should be used to cover so specific testing. So, and yes, at this point we come, you know, to a natural solution. Then it doesn't matter how long you listen to me. So, in one day, or maybe today, or maybe tomorrow, so you need to sit down and somehow just read and learn more about the specific testing. Then you can talk about this. So then you have so this. Put this in your head, implement it in your mind, so then how it's work, in at least theoretically. So because it will help you to pass and get in the door. And believe me, this again, you don't need to be scared. This interview is a showtime. After showtime, when you get the offer and accept the job, so then first 3 weeks you will be like overloaded and 24/7 learn. But so after you made it, everything situated, so nobody really will push pressure. So this, you will be the one who will put pressure to catch everything quickly. So because in every company I know, from everybody that I know, this so they tell story. So they always first couple weeks, 3 weeks, it's always easy going. So they not, yeah, you get a lot of information, but it's not really high expectation. Then so they expect you from you full, or they give you full load of. Real jobs, so this really daily task. So, okay, I'm sorry that I'm late, so, but, yeah, I have just couple words to say about specific for mobile game testing, because it's a huge area. I can talk about this 4 hours, so specifically when I have friends who work directly in industry, but when it comes to game testing, you know, it's a huge area, then you look like multi-layers, so what is going on, and at this point, so there's three elephants of gaming. It's functionality, usability, and performance. Because also if it's a very advanced, cool games, but very slow, people uninstall. So when it's, you know, this super performance, but game is boring, uninstall. So this, if it's, you know, this not upgrade store there, something, so this story is not really like, or it's not intuitive for user to figure it out, and he need always listen and read some instruction where to go and what to do, uninstall. So it's like critical things, so for gaming. Believe it or not, this most of the money is that's going through the game industry. It's exactly upgrade store and so different kind of bonuses and share on social network. And for your example, so this I give this example all the time because it's from first hand. So this you know, we take the top 100 of iPhone game, not the games, but just application. So there's one application. You don't need to be, you know, huge companies or to be millionaires. So because one small application, so in the number of somewhere in the rating 80, 90, so this really like load of hundreds, so we'll make about 20 to 50,000 a month. So top 10 make about, so between 1.5 to 5 million a month, so dollars, yeah. So just one small application can be the so this golden egg for rest of your life. So it's why, but why I tell you this, not impress or you just like skip it and don't want to be tester anymore, but decide to be game developer. But what is the direction to go? You know, this when you work for game company, then they like do some really strange and wild things for employees. So then, yeah, we don't tell some small thing like free food or free drink or things like that. But it's a lot of free activities because they can afford it to spend this extra dollar for cool guys who create cool games. So because they know then return will be 10,000 times more. So when we talk about game testing, it's a special area of global monetization system. So we also this lot of games, believe it or not, so it depends on security and analytics testing. So specifically when it's a yeah, we're still talking, I'm sorry. Mike was surprised that we're still online, so and you're still on live. Thank you, guys. We're almost done, so I just need to share a couple more resources with you, and we're done. So, and for example, this how the game, any module, this or how this game develop. You have some special add-ons or extension for each module, and it's some kind of analytics so application. And every click, every move of fingers to this so gamer is recorded, and after this statistic is analyzed, and at the end of the month, so report is on the table of developers so in a team. It's like to see what feature is most useful, what is really this people use, what is intuitive, what is not. And at some point, you know, when they develop a game, so this what direction they need to go, this what people, what armor is most, you know, this like useful for people, what upgrade is numbers is the biggest, so this what they can enhance and what they just can dissolve and eliminate because it's nobody care. Or if it's important for me as for producer, then how I can enhance so this specific so small upgrades of feature or option or tabs or buttons, then it will be more user intuitive and friendly, and it's finally will recognize and so to gain my points. So maybe to click on this button will link to some special page that I'm really after, so to get the bugs. And one more thing, this, you know, people think this, how this gamer, I mean, how this a game company to get the money. They generally this, they get this through the stores, so this iStore or Google Play, but it's not by how many times application is installed, but how many times application install as well. So this it's like real rating of the games and real rating of popularity, so this how it's created. So it's a different, so eventually this, you know, this company will get paid from this differential between install and uninstall. So it's a catch. And you know this, when we talk about gaming, then it's a heavily agile environment. Sometimes it's extreme programming. I work with extreme programming. Actually, you know, it's nothing too extreme. It was super fun because you have table of three, you have like two developer, and you have me as a tester. So two developer do the same part of code at the same time. So and for some specific module or feature, so they done, they don't look there. So they creatively so create from their perspective how each of them thinking. So they give me immediately under test. I'm testing it. I give them feedback. And they compare this what code is better. And at this point, you know, it's a really proven situation. Then it's eliminate up to 70% of errors. So for product at full, it's a, like really super cool. But you know, you must be team. So and you must be really like in fun mode to do this. So it's not like you competitors. So or you try to you know just so be a mean person. No, you just have a fun. You like so it's about ping pong. Catch it, catch it. All right, cool. So this hey, give it to me. You know what? He did this better. His coat is shorter and things like that. You know this. I mean, if you live in this, and I mean, it's not for everybody, but it's really like was fun environment. And with, when we talk about gaming testing, we also need to consider so game psychology things because many times. So it's, you know, this you need to put yourself in a gamer shoe, this and be in a, like, character things, you know, this as behave like a character and as a character, so what you expect and what you want, so like zombie or whatever. So, and we, again, if you proceed for any entertainment, social network or gaming company or so this guys who work with the product. So first of things, then you need to learn and be prepared and they can ask, or maybe it's just somehow come an interview. So it will be open ID account. So you need to know what is open ID is, maybe create open ID account for yourself. So just to start to use this by yourself, then you can talk what it is and how cool is that specifically in gaming industry. So also if you don't believe, then it's a cool, and maybe you're concerned or scared, but so for gaming industry, it's a super cool, I'm telling you. So, and we also just consider it's a game apps development, native versus hybrid versus web games. It's all different specific. And test approach, because it could be ad hoc all the time, it could be sprint check, it could be like really huge, so developing of this test plan and test cases. So, and again, just to give you a clue, so if it's come under consideration, I have some couple so this test cases for games specifically. But for example, zombie implants. I mean, it's not really advanced big games. Maybe like so 12 levels. So and believe it or not, so just for one release of these games, people executed manually about between 2,000 to 3,000 test cases. So it's and it's yeah. It's a big, I mean, it's like five tester will work on it. So, yeah, like more and more about, so this, I go back. Oh, sorry. Okay, so thank you for your patience. I'm sorry. I don't know how long it's take because, so it's just, again, it's all brand new stuff that I cover today. So I mentioned for you RDA. And again, at this point, it's a self-exploratory. This I give you links. I so this give you some clue of advantage and disadvantages of RDA. And I plan in the next couple months because I have special so this access to device anywhere and perfect mobile normal. This it's not. So I just tell you this. You have a link. So you will have some very minimum tutorials there, but you will not have full access or you cannot try to play around because it's not for individual. It's only for companies and it's a special. So payable services, for example, like device anywhere costs $7,000 a year. So that I don't think then you will so really willing to pay $7,000 for playing some tests so, or whatever. So, but it's very cool stuff. And I plan to create some webinars for that in the next couple of months and put this in part of resources. So, and what is, you know, this, it's very common questions these days because, again, people got confusion and it's, you know, it's a special tricky question check mark. So by asking you what you think about emulator and simulator, so to prove that are you really work in the mobile industry or not, are you really work with emulator and simulators? So, and I create for you this, like, explanation, so in, you know, this compile form, so this little bit more information, what is emulator and what is simulator and how they differ from each other. So I'm very thankful for a wonderful presentation. All right, cool. So let me finish, okay? I try to right now, so just go faster, so because it's already, I know you guys tired, and I appreciate that you're so long with me. So I will not go through this because, again, I'm 100% sure you will be so eligible and so willing to read this sooner or later. So, but again, here's a special golden clue for, you know, mobile testing automation tools. So with the links, because again, it's 1,000 on the mark, but what is the popular, what is the most common and useful? So this, I tell you, Robotium, this, you know, it was like a hot spot a year ago. So right now these people, it's a buggy. So it's a half couple crashes and people starting drawback a little bit. I mean, it's still cool. Sequely, so Phone Monkey, any so Gorilla Logic product, so I will really encourage you to go and explore more. Eggplant is very useful. So this Test Quest Pro is also this on the market. So again, try to at least, you know, this if you read and if you find then something easy for you to understand and work around this, each of these websites, they have some tutorial, or if you go YouTube and you know keyword, you will find some special tutorial and information about this. So try to create your story. I don't ask you to lie, but again, so you know this, to pass interview and really start work hard. So sometimes we need to be actors, so this, you know, to make performances, so to make a show, so to get our chance in life. So, and I don't think that it's wrong, because, you know, more likely, so we're not really cheating, because to get this performance well done, to get a job, it's a really also hard job. So this, you need to learn a lot. So you need to force yourself, you motivate yourself, and you need to, you know, this read and go through a lot of things. And that's why I am not consider this cheating. So, but if it's give you open a door, so to some good profession, so the, to like really a new world, so then why not? We all the specifically, if we in America, I don't know this, you may be around the world at this point, but in the United States, it's a country of opportunity, and I want to get my opportunity. I want to catch a wave. So it's why this, so I will create a story and I will choose one or two of this automation tools and explore more, so read more. Try to, you know, get some tutorial through the internet, so, and implement this in my resume and tell them, so yes, I have hands-ons. So this, yes, I was working with these things maybe 1 or 2 years ago. It's a lot of updates, but again, generally, I understand how it's work. I will catch on. So, and things like that. Sorry, maybe I'm a liar, but so I got my jobs. So, and it's just a small things I already mentioned. So then, you know, this, we need to, it's just very easy question. So this, do you ever hurt? Oops. Oh, man. Okay. Sorry. I will adjust this things, the links. Hey, sorry. But again, this, the main things in this page, it's a link, you know, this, and what does this things mean? So what is all this abbreviation for? So TrueBrew certification or Symbian sign test criteria or Java verified program. So because if you work with and go proceed for some really clouds or company then relay and some and work with server product, so more likely they will ask a question, do you know about this certification, because it's a part of a very specific mobile testing. So and this link will guide you exactly to so overview of processes, what exactly will be covered step by step. So this, I was going through like 3 or 4 links to find a good one. So and the last thing then, it's a question that I was planned to cover, and I was not having time. Sorry, but again, it's a clue. Also, if I cannot, so I was just start exploring, and because location-based services, mobile application, it's a like huge area. So, and you can cover just from simple so spot easy navigation and tracking, sorry, maps and navigation, so tracking services or information services or application itself. But again, it's at least it's give you clue, because if you go proceed for company and it's somehow this, you know, then you look at the product and you understand that the product heavily relate, or maybe just part of this relate on geolocation or any of this so location based services, you better explore, because it's again, it's a specific testing for this, and I just don't have was not having time to put links, so I have this in my extra file. So, but again, I will try to update this file so in a couple of weeks, and you always will. So on Wednesday, I will have updated version under Partnov resources. Then you can go to some Partnov data. What is the name of these things? www.partnov.com, data mobile testing, and you will see this, my three presentations there. It's actually like a little bit bigger and updated, so this from what we have in the online class. Okay, so at this point, I have a lot of other materials is for you, but don't worry, I will not spend time for this. One of this, so this I just last 2-3 minutes. So mobile technology in the near future, why I create so many slides for that? Because I want blew your mind. I want you to think out of box. I want you to get excited when you actually work on a search industry, or you will plan to work in search profession. Then, you know, you will test stuff which is not on the market, which is know-how, like nobody see, and you're the first guy who not just put a hands on it, but try to break it. So it's super cool, you know, to prove that this product is good enough, well enough, so secure enough, and things like that. So, and it's you know, this we think all the time, we talk all the time, so for this last 6 hours about so just simple iPhone and Androids, so that it's like so much more than that. And I want you to open your eyes and see what is available, what is not just signed feature, but it's on the market, so and it's already patented, and it's work, and it will work. So you may be the next who will work with that. So I have a lot of YouTube links, and I encourage you to watch all this video, because this knowledge give you not just excitement, but motivation during interview to talk about this, like how I love this subject. Man, I'm just like completely in love, and I want to work in this industry. So, and naturally, this is a bunch of helpful resources and links. Then, so I really don't want to expand in this presentation itself, but so here's a different diagrams that you can use for your portfolio, so then you will not clone from Partnov Computer School, then you will be individual, so this who prepare for interview different way. So, and at this point, I really appreciate that you stay with me for so long, so, and look for updates at Partnov.com. We're done. Hooray! Stop recording.